Hey everybody, Mark Salas here, Best Realty. I got Trey Whitlock, insurance specialist, here with us again. We're going to talk about fire scores. This is something else that's very important, something that a lot of people don't even think about. So we have all kinds of different terrains here in Colorado Springs. So we got some terrains that are flat, we got some Broadmoor Bluffs area, we got Black Forest, and the fire score is going to affect the insurance quote and the payment per month and per year, correct?
And possibly the eligibility of having the insurance, period.
Exactly, yeah. So there are some areas that you could say, or the insurance company can say, hey, listen, we're not going to insure this area, it's too much of a risk, right?
Correct. So we use a system called CoreLogic, which is a national system that's a database that goes down to the latitude and longitude of the property and says, you know, on a scale of 1 to 100 usually, some go 1 to 10, but usually it's 1 to 100, you know, how much of a risk there is for wildfire.
Okay.
So, like, with some companies, they'll take everything from 80 down. Some companies will take from 90 down. There are a couple that may take in the 90s, but a lot of times if you're above that 90 on that fire score, then the company is basically just going to tell you, sorry, we don't cover that.
And I've heard that the fire score is affected by the distance to a fire hydrant, the distance to a fire station, the grade of the land. Is that correct? Have you heard any of that?
The ISO score is typically what has to do with how close the water source or the fire department is.
Gotcha.
The wildfire score typically is going to be based more on just how much fuel there is on that lot.
Gotcha.
Like if it's a tree lot in Black Forest and there's no separation from the trees in the house, you're going to have a high fire score.
Gotcha.
If you've got, you know, the back side of the house is just goes into acreage of trees, but the front side is empty, you're still going to have a fire score because they're looking at the chance that a wildfire, if it were to happen, how likely it is that house could be affected by it.
Okay, all right, that makes sense. Now, I know here in Pikes Peak Regional Building Department, I don't know if it's national, I know Pikes Peak Regional Building Department, we have what we call a hillside ordinance. They determine before a property is built the grade of the land. If it's over 10%, they call it a hillside ordinance, and if you're building a home, they'll make you either put a fire alarm system in or a fire suppression system. I've seen them where they do both. I don't know where the cutoff is or when they require it, when they don't require it, but that goes back to insurance. Do you guys give discounts if someone has a fire alarm system or a fire suppression system in their home?
Typically any safety features, you know, fire suppression, even the smoke detectors can get you something sometimes, ring doorbell, any security features.
Okay.
You can get some discount for having fire alarm systems, especially if they're monitored and on a secured line.
Okay.
Burglar, so thefts, that kind of stuff. It doesn't necessarily mean that having those fire suppression systems are going to affect whether a company is going to take you if you're in like one of those higher categories.
Fire score. Yeah. So the fire score is just basically the underlying, if you're going to do the policy. Or not.
Correct.
Yeah. If they're eligible, or if that property is eligible.
Or if that property needs more mitigation done to bring it to an eligible status.
Okay.
So you may have to do, some companies will ask you to do 30 feet of clearance on every side of the house. Some will ask for 75 or 80 feet. Some will go up to 100, 150 feet. That doesn't mean you have to clear cut. That means you have to mitigate and, you know, no pine needles, no huge clumps of trees, no rows of trees that basically lead directly to the house where if that sparks, it's just going to chain reaction all the way to the house, that kind of thing.
That makes sense.
So,
Yeah. And I've seen it a couple different ways. I've seen clients, or I've had clients who are building, and of course, usually when someone's building custom builds, I see it a lot in Black Forest and mountains, you know, sort of looking for their dream home.
Right.
Is there any way to determine, hey, we find a plot, this is the land that we want, can we call the insurance company and say, what's my fire score on this lot? This is the address. Would you guys be able to give us a fire score?
We could probably give a fire score on the lot.
Okay.
But that's not going to be the same fire score that it's going to be after
it's built. So that's available.
Because you can build in the mitigation when you're doing that.
Okay.
You know, Black Forest Monument, some of those areas that do have trees, though, most of the time, customers are buying the house there because they want a treated lot.
Exactly.
They're not looking to clear cut, you know, all the way around the tree or around the house. But at the same time, if you want to have insurance or if you want to try to get affordable insurance, you may have to take it to a little negotiation to where you're actually mitigating enough that it becomes something that is feasible.
And it's insurable or it reduces the price. So you guys will look at that. You'll take a look at everything. So the biggest point is if you guys are looking at a property, no matter what it is, talk with your insurance agent. Make sure you get some of these questions answered, especially if it's in the trees, if it's in the mountains, things like that. They look at the fire scores and it will affect your rate. We'll have Trey's information here, but if you guys have any questions, feel free to give either one of us a call. Thank you so much.
No problem.